Брестом и Гродно.
Looking emboldened with messages of support from Russia, Alexander Lukashenko says there'll be a bloodbath if he's forced from the presidency of Belarus.
I want to protect what we spent 25 years creating. There are thousands, millions of people behind me. They're the ones I'm worried about. I'm not worried about power, as some in Russia say. Luka is clinging on with blue hands. I don't want them to cut my country up after I glued it together after the broken pieces of the Soviet Empire.
There have been 4 weeks of peaceful protests in the capital Minsk since Lukashenko said he won 80% of the vote for his re-election. The EU, US and UK say voting was neither free nor fair. Russia's foreign minister says, without providing evidence, that what he described as 200 extremists from Ukraine have infiltrated the protests and are trying to stir up violence.
We have confirmation that this is being directed from Ukraine territory. There are non-government organizations working to provoke radical events in Minsk and other Belarus towns.
Russia has been in conflict with Ukraine for 6 years. Lavrov, who met his Belarus counterpart on Wednesday, said NATO and EU calls for new elections are destructive. Lithuania's foreign minister told Al Jazeera he thinks Russia is making a strategic mistake by backing Lukashenko.
Unfortunately, Russia still continues to support this compromised leadership, not understanding that only democratic process could lead out of this, this situation. And what their reasoning, it's another question. Maybe they believe it's their weakness if they will give up or somehow to sacrifice this leader, which is totally compromised. But they're risking really also to have this backlash back home. And frankly, they're also risking to spoil relations with the people of Belarus, because they are not anti-Russian.
Lithuania, Latvia and Estonia have imposed travel bans on Lukashenko and 28 other members of his government and want the rest of the EU to follow suit.
On Thursday, Russia's prime minister heads to Minsk, and on Friday, Belarus's defense minister is in Moscow. All indications that the Kremlin is sticking by Alexander Lukashenko. The European Union hasn't taken sides, but it has called for new elections and for the imposition of sanctions on those it says are responsible for election fraud and violence against protesters. Bernard Smith, Al Jazeera, Vilnius.